Welcome to Podcasts, recorded live at the Center for Spiritual Living in Portland, Oregon. We have many programs, classes, and workshops developed just for our online audience. To find out more, go to our website at cslportland.org and look under the Online tab. Our mission is to open hearts, ignite minds, and make a difference. If you'd like to support our center and its video podcast, you can donate online at cslportland.org/donate. Allow us to become part of your extended spiritual community. Wherever you are on your spiritual journey, you are most welcome at the Center for Spiritual Living.
Good morning. How's everyone doing this morning? Thumbs up.
Good.
Yeah. Woohoo. All right. Well, shall we stand and sing together? Holy, Holy Way. The lyrics are in your bulletins. However, it's one of those songs where you can just repeat after me, so that makes it simple.
Welcome to the Portland Center for Spiritual Living. We are a science of mind community that teaches and practices spiritual principles that transform our lives and make the world a better place. Wherever you are on your spiritual journey, you are welcome here. All we ask is that you stay open to the possibility of changing your entire life, starting by changing your mind. My name is Nadine Muller. My pronouns are she, her. I serve as a licensed spiritual practitioner here. It is my honor and joy to welcome you. Is there anyone new in the sanctuary today? Yay! Welcome. Is there anyone new with our virtual spiritual community? I know, right? Raise your hand on Facebook Live. Please let us know in the chat so that we can welcome you. If you're new to the center and in person, there are welcome packets. Oops, I'm going to lose this. There are welcome packets on the back. So I hope you got a welcome packet. Did you get one?
No, because she's just visiting.
That's okay. You can still have one. We love having you here. No. So if you're new to the center and in person, there are welcome packets on the table in the back of the sanctuary. The same packet information is available for our global community on our website at cslportland.org under the About Us menu tab. Both contain information about who we are, what we stand for, and how we might serve you. And on our website, you can sign up for weekly emails that detail our events, register for classes, and even get a free gift on your birthday. And please, please use those gifts. They're really wonderful. And here's our announcements. Everyone is welcome to join our weekly practitioner-led Wednesday night meditation on Zoom. This week, Wednesday, August 14th at 7 p.m., the online meditation is titled Cosmic Prayer, and it will be facilitated by practitioner emerita Kate Barrett. The Zoom links for the meditation are on our website. And this is a big special announcement. Please mark your calendars for a joyful time in the community on Sunday, September 8th at 11 a.m., because together we will celebrate the ordination of Reverend Marilyn Sprague. Our new senior minister, Reverend Bridget McCann, will be presenting, and Reverend Dr. Larry King will be ordaining Reverend Marilyn. Music will be by LaRonda Steele, and there'll be a reception immediately following the service. So now for our upcoming educational opportunities. A 10-week virtual certificated class is scheduled, titled Exploring the Roots of Science of Mind. There are no prerequisites. Anyone can take this class, and I advise that you do, because it's a wonderful, wonderful class. Plus, I'm the TA, so you know it's got to be good. So it's scheduled for Tuesday evenings from 6 to 9, September 24th to November 6th, in the Zoom classroom. And you will embark on a journey into the historical origins of Ernest Holmes' transformative philosophy. There will be a specific focus on the influential works of Thomas Troward, Emma Curtis Hopkins, and Ralph Waldo Emerson. This course serves as a rich tapestry of knowledge as you delve into the intellectual and spiritual foundations that shape the science of mind teachings. It's co-facilitated by Reverend Marilyn Sprague and Kate Barrett, practitioner emerita. This is our A-team. Sign up on our website, cslportland.org, and details, including the Zoom link, will be sent to you on registration. And now I have a couple of special announcements. We actually could use some help, and PCSL needs a part-time assistant to work with our bookkeeper, Diane Thomas. This is a paid position, about 3 hours a week, and Diane will be training you. If you're interested, please contact Diane at bookkeeper@cslportland.org. Or you can either, you know, come up to any one of the board members and let us know that you're interested. Sacred service. We also need some help with volunteers. Are you feeling called to serve your spiritual community? Do you have gifts and time that you would like to share with us? We are recruiting volunteers to serve in several different and fun capacities. Curious? Are you? Come on. Please see Kat Hooker. Kat, can you raise your hand? She's in the back. Or you can fill out the yellow sacred service form on the welcome table near the door. Or you can email Kat at kat.hooker.pcsl@gmail.com. Licensed practitioners Kathy Batten and Donna Wallace are serving on High Watch today, holding a sacred container of consciousness in the sanctuary and for our virtual spiritual community. Today, our special music features Lauri Jones. And our wonderful Friends Band. Today's message, The Unexplained, Seen and Unseen, is by Reverend Barbara Wuest. And our flowers are courtesy of Cat Jacobs. So sit back and relax, because I know that somewhere between this beautiful spiritual community, the music, the meditation, and the message is exactly what your heart came to receive.
So just breathing into the right here, right now. Allowing the music and the beautiful vibration in this room to wash over and through you. God is, I am, and sing if you are so inspired. God is, I am, right here, right now, right here, right now, God is, I am, God is.
There is an energy, an intelligence, a unified order in back of all. There is only the one life, one love, one mind. And this one expresses and experiences through its multitude of creations, each creation a unique and integral part of the whole. Everything seen and unseen is the manifest expression of God. As spirit is all there is, I know that I am a part of it. All the qualities of spirit are within me. The love, light, wisdom, joy, peace, harmony. It is all good, and it is all God. I know this is true for me, and I know this is true for each and every one of us across the planet. Raising our consciousness above the effects of the human condition, we feel, sense, and know that there is only love, with a capital L. Our entire being is perfect God life. We are God in expression, and we claim harmony, love, peace, wisdom, and joy. God's love and harmony fills our existence. We trust the power of God love because it eases our path, creates beauty, and converts fear into faith. Resting in this knowledge and grateful for this truth, I release my word into the action and activity of the law, which always says yes. Yes, my beloved. I let it be, I allow it to be. And together we say, and so it is. So please take a few moments to stay within this sacred space and commune with the one love.
Did you feel like kind of taking a little nap there? Ah, thank you so much, Lauri, and the Friends Band. Thank you so much. I'm going to swap things today. Some of you might not know that I'm doing this because you're new here and you've never been here before. I'm going to do a prayer first, and I have reasons for it that you'll hear about it at the end. I think the bridge pedal is going on or something. So anyone who lives on the west side is still in traffic or has turned around and gone home. I've actually gotten some texts from people. It took me 50 minutes to get here. Normally it takes me like 25. So what I want to do is take the energy that's already been created and lift it. Can you feel it? Like, are your hair sticking up? And we're going to take this energy and send it to everyone who is frustrated and in traffic and or just having a, like that book, a no good, very bad day. Yeah. You ever had one of those? And also, I wanted to send energy off also to Reverend Bridget. As you know, some of you know, last Sunday, she let us all know that she'd been diagnosed with breast cancer, but caught at the very, 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 very beginning. And so she's at the coast with some friends, and what a place to be. Talk about energy, right? So whatever that is where you draw energy from, if it's the beach, if it's from music, if it's from nature, if it's from music, if it's whatever, bring that into your mind right now. Bring that into your mind. Close your eyes. Take a deep breath in and let it go. And imagine that there is a line from the top of your head that is pulling up. Therefore, you sit up just a little straighter. See, somebody else is running behind and they want us to know. So sitting up a little straighter, allow your shoulders just to relax and go back a little bit. And when this happens, when our shoulders relax and go back, physically it opens up our heart center more, so that we are open and allowed to create that energy that moves through us. So this energy that comes from around, comes from inside, visualize it actually moving out from your heart center right now and embracing all, anyone in need of prayer or in need of a little boost with this energy. You can add yourself into this prayer as well, as it lifts us each up. And just quietly repeat after me, I am strong. I am brave. I can do this. And as we say together to end a prayer, and so it is. Thank you. I needed that. It's just so amazing how a focused time, an intentional focused time, like what we just did, can uplift and energize. I mean, even though I feel it's still kind of quiet, that's okay. I'll change that in a minute. But there's still that energy that's flowing. I mean, I can feel it coming up and out. So thank you, thank you, thank you so much for that. So faith is an example of something that is unseen, yet we show it by prayer or meditation or dancing or whatever that is, and the outcome being that we are allowing God, nature, spirit to move through us. So it's the unseen, the unexplained, and the seen that I'm talking about today. St. Augustine said this, faith is to believe what you do not see. The reward of this faith is to see what you believe. Faith is to believe what you do not see, the unseen. The reward is to see what you believe. I just love that. I think it's a cool thing. So we affect energy around us. You could feel that when we were just exchanging this energy. We affect everything outside of us, always. Sometimes if we're home or in our cars or whatever, we think, oh, we're not affecting anybody. We are, because our energy goes out there. Tim Wilde said this, did you know that your energy field extends around you for a 20-mile radius? Wow. See what I mean? It's like every single thought, word, and deed has a resonant effect. This immediately alters the construction of the matrix around others in our proximity. Say, for example, you leave your house feeling bright, lit up, and fifth dimensional. I love this terminology. Can't you just hear that song, Age of Aquarius, going through your mind? Okay. All other entering your space, even for a short period of time, will adopt this higher frequency. This is how energy moves and forms, reforms, by adopting its highest state of expression. It is so very easy to change the world around you. All it takes is the energy and the decision to do so. So imagine that, a 20-mile radius. Basically, you can't even see as far as your energy goes. And yet it goes and goes and goes. And what I know is it comes back around too. And if we all aim towards that highest vibration, imagine how we can inform the places that we are coming into. Like if you're coming into the space, if you're 20 miles away, know that what your energy is like is going to meet you at the door at a higher vibration, possibly because of the energy that's here already. You see how that works? It's kind of fun. From Emotion Code, Dr. Bradley Nelson, he's a chiropractor and wrote this amazing book I recommended, Emotion Code. Our health greatly depends on the quality of energy that flows through and makes up our bodies. We can compare this energy to electricity. We can't see electricity, but we can feel it. Electricity is colorless and odorless. It is invisible, yet it is certainly real. If you've ever stuck your finger in a light socket or been shocked getting toast out of the toaster, then you know what I mean. I will also say putting a knife in to get the toast out before unplugging it, I'm not saying that I've done that. It hurts. So electricity, you can't see it, but we all trust in it. It's the same with gravity. We trust in it, but we can't see it. So there is so much in the unseen world that we give credit to, but we forget also the energy that is moving through us as well. Tony Robbins did a foreword for this book, and he said, "We have to include human emotion on the list of forces that shape us. Love, hate, fear, anger, and gratitude are just a few emotions that uniquely and powerfully impact life as much as anything else on the planet. Emotions are vibrations of pure energy, each having its own unique vibrational frequency. Everything in this universe is made of energy, and emotions are no exception." So think about that. Your thoughts, your words, your decisions, and your actions all have energy. Makes me start thinking a little bit, oh wait, who did I say that to the other day? Wow, that wasn't being very thoughtful, was it? I'll give you an example of how impactful energy can be. And I'm going to change the names to protect the innocent. This is going to be Fred and Lisa and a 12-year-old son. So I'm back in the Boston area, and it's majorly muggy, that which has nothing to do with anything, it's just that it's muggy. And we're driving in the car, and we're headed to take the 12-year-old to mom's house. And the 12-year-old had to get there because he was having a play date. Well, we had had this arrangement to do something with some family beforehand, and plans changed with the 12-year-old, and his buddy wasn't going to come for an extra hour, like we needed to move everything out an hour. Well, he did let his mother know. Now, this is a woman, well, anyway, I'll get there. So we're in the car driving, and Lisa calls up his 12-year-old son. He's on the phone, yes, 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 we're on our way, and I can kind of hear her, so you know how loudly she's talking. And finally he says, "Here, Dad, you need to talk to Mom." Dad's driving. And Dad is a terrible driver anyway. The last thing he needs to do is grab a phone and put it up to his ear, right? So what do? I grab the phone, and I get on the phone to Lisa and say, "Lisa, you know what? Fred is driving right now, and we're going to be there soon, and da-da-da. And the 12-year-old had told Mom when she called the first time, oh, yeah, plans changed. My buddy's not coming over for an extra hour, da-da-da-da-da. She couldn't let it go. So I'm talking to her. I said, you know, we'll be there soon. We're going to be there in plenty of time, da-da-da. Hang up the phone, give it back to the 12-year-old. Phone rings again. It's Mom. Dad, Mom wants to talk to you. I grab the phone again. Why? I'm learning. This is learning my learning phase, right? I grab the phone again and say, you know, Lisa, Fred's driving. I really would prefer, you know, if we're going to get there. No, I need to talk to him. So finally, Fred just says, give me the phone. I put it on voice,
speaker.
Say it again?
Speaker.
Thank you, speaker. Because I'm thinking, he took it off speaker and held it up to his phone because we could hear. Okay, so we get there in plenty of time, but I can feel the energy now. This was 8 years ago, and I can still feel. So that energy is just going through me like, you know, is it different in Massachusetts? Is it okay to be on your phone when you're driving or not? I don't know. I thought not, which was the case. But I'm thinking she's putting us in jeopardy because he's driving. Not only that, but two kids were in the back. There was an older son, like a 20-year-old also, and a 12-year-old, and me, and it's not okay. But I had been around this situation for a while and realized that Fred was constantly emotionally and verbally abused by her, and I had had it up to here. We get there, and I get out of the car. They're all out. She's sitting in their swimming pool, just kind of lounging around, and that, my fire just went up. Plus, I'm a fire sign, so it was like, woo. The dog, who is not a very nice dog and just really, like, comes up to you and just growls, came over to me. This is energy. Immediately put his tail between his legs, turned around, and walked away. And I thought, oh, my God, that energy that I have is not just in those moments and in all moments. It shocked me awake to what I was creating and putting out in a 20-mile radius. It was not okay, but I was learning how to deal in that situation. I had not, when I see people that are abused like that, I just, it doesn't work. I can't zip my lip. It just, stuff comes out. So, needless to say, I moved back here. So anyway, on Facebook, I try to be a good person, but then someone pulls out in front of me doing 10 below the speed limit, and I got to try again tomorrow. Okay, so maybe I haven't changed as much as that. And yet, there are times I think each of us are nudged to do something differently or to go someplace or whatever that is, we get a nudge. The other day I got a nudge, and I wish I could take you all to the moment that it happened. I did my walk in the morning, came home, and I usually when I'm speaking, I have like a deadline. I want to get my talk done by this day. And I felt like listening to my nudge was going to make me like intentionally be slow at doing what I really wanted to do, right? But I listened to the nudge, and I went out. The nudge said, go sit outside for a while. And I have created this amazing space outside. I have a chair that looks like a little basket that I sit in. I can look at my yard, and behind my yard there's a park. Nobody goes, it's just like lots of trees and animals come through. And I sat there, and I just was enjoying the time and not procrastinating, really, because of the nudge. And all of a sudden, this mama squirrel, and I know she was a mama squirrel because she had a baby in her mouth, and she was hopping along the top of my fence. And it's a short fence, so I could see her the whole way. And it's like she made a trip, but I'm thinking, what is that in her mouth? And I finally figured out what it was, her baby. So she comes back, goes back again, another baby. And I'm sitting there going, this is the coolest thing in the world. Goes back again, gets baby number 3, goes back again, and by this point I'm thinking, okay, if she's going back again, she's getting another baby, I want to film this. So So I had my phone like all ready, and it actually worked because she stopped midway with one of her babies. So I could really see what she was doing. And what I was saying about energy, she knew she was safe. The environment that's created there is safe. And she stopped to let me actually see her baby. Now, she did go back again, and I think for at least number five, but my next door neighbor, I heard her come out, and that kind of shifted things. I could see that she probably wasn't going to be coming back again. So I looked it up. Thank God for internet, right? I looked it up because I was curious. Why is she moving all these babies? Is something, a predator around? Which is a high probability there, because behind where I live, because it's all that green space, we have coyotes and deer. We have hawks and eagles that live around there too. And they usually make 3 to 4 nests, which I did not know. For that reason, if they're predators, they'll move their babies about 6 weeks when they're 6 weeks old, and or that their fleas get in their nest. So it was really, you learn something new every day, right? But the wonderful thing was she trusted me. My energy was good. I had created the space. And she gave me a huge gift. Appreciating nature, I love it. Doris Hoskins says this, in science, we call it energy. In religion, we call it spirit. In the streets, we call it vibes. All I'm saying is, trust it. Trust it. You know, there is the unexplainable, the unseen in the seen, and many, many, many different experiences that we all have. And I'm sure many of you have had some of these experiences. I want to tell you about one time I went to Indonesia, and it was with a spiritual group. So right there, the energy is already lifted, right? That's not necessarily true now that I think about it in some traditions, but in this case, it was. We were all really lifted, and we went to Java, a place called Borobudur. There's a temple there. And when you go into the temple, you walk around. It's shaped around. There are many areas where it's round. And you go up the stairs, and you're going circling, circling, circling till you get to the top. And before I got to the top, I stood and put my hands on the walls there. I mean, these are old, ancient temples. And I closed my eyes. And I could see, I didn't know how to delineate it necessarily, but for me, it was almost as if I had been there hundreds of years prior, carrying a tray of gifts for the gods. Now, whether it was me in a past life, I don't know, I believe in that, or it was me feeling the energy of what occurred there, I'm not sure, and it doesn't matter. The idea is that that energy still lives in those stones. It still lives there, and I could feel it. Another trip, Israel. Went to the Dead Sea, many places, but this one in particular, went to the Dead Sea. And as I'm sure most of you would know that in the 50s, I think it was in the 50s, there were some scrolls found in caves there, and they call them the Dead Sea Scrolls. And it helped to explain more of what really happened during Jesus' time in his life and made it. A lot of them have not been published for purposes of the patriarchy during the time. But anyway, energetically, there were these findings of this great wisdom. Now, we were standing on an area, and if you've ever been there, it's very arid in this by the Dead Sea. And that's why they call it the Dead Sea. Very arid. And you can look out over all these rocks and formations, and you can actually see cave openings there. So I went up to the wall yet again, put my hands on the wall, and tears started coming down. And what came to me was, they haven't found all of them yet. And I could see myself, vision, whatever, my hair's all standing up on end, putting these scrolls into these amazing barrels. They're not barrels, they're... Yeah, except without water, but pottery, in these pottery and putting lid on, and that's how they kept them safe. But I could see it. I could see in my mind that there were some hidden other places. Now, I couldn't tell looking out there where that might be, but I knew that there were more. Now, I don't think since I was on that trip that any more have been found. Doesn't matter. Again, it's the energy. Whatever energy of the individuals was that took these scrolls as sacred permeates that whole area. With the tears coming down my eyes, one of the women on the trip came up behind me and she said, "You've been here before, haven't you?" Not in this form. She knew. She could feel it as well. There is energy in everything. Whether you're feeling that energy on a site or not doesn't matter. It's just remember that energy is everywhere in everything. Sometimes, well, a lot of times, for me anyway, the universe likes to crack a joke and have fun with me on some of these things. Another trip, this wasn't with a spiritual group, although walking into the Sistine Chapel, you know you're going to feel some stuff, right? And if you've ever been there, you're in these long lines, which is fine. You know, it's just the anticipation of getting in there. Walk down these long stairs to finally you get to the door where you get to go inside. And you walk in, and there's a platform that you have to walk, kind of like this. You have to walk across the platform, down some stairs, and then down into the main holding area where up above you are all the paintings, the beautiful paintings. So hold that here as an aside for anyone who doesn't know, which maybe most of you don't. My favorite rock band is Journey. And I love Journey music. Now, some of you might know some of theirs. I'll try to catch you up in a minute if you don't. So just hold that there too. Okay, so we're in the Sistine Chapel. As I'm walking along the platform, there are guards there that are waving you along saying, "Don't stop, don't stop, don't stop, don't stop." I kid you freaking not. I'm walking over, and that's what I'm hearing is, "Don't stop." I'm walking over, I get to this one guard. He says, "Don't stop believing." And I froze. Okay, so Journey song, "Don't Stop Believing," if you've never heard it. I froze. And he's like, "Don't stop believing." And I went. So I started singing it. "Don't stop believing." You know that? "Hold on to that feeling." And we had this thing for like a minute. And then I walked off, and it was like, whatever happened to him, he was back to his, "Don't stop, don't stop." Now, come on. Really? You know, that is energy. That is God. That is spirit. That is the higher source, the higher power, love, the higher love. It's whatever you want to call it. It happens all the time. All the time. And that was one of my favorite times that it happened. I couldn't wait to go tell somebody. You know, like, this really did happen. I promise, I swear it did. Some of you, this is from Facebook, one of my favorite books. Some of you are walking love letters and you don't even realize it. You're lighting up rooms, shifting atmosphere, and carrying inspiration just by being you. Such a precious gift. Take that in. Instead of some of you are walking love letters, all of you are walking love letters. I had a recent experience where I was communicating with somebody via text. Now, I love all of our electronics and stuff, except when you're trying to get a good connection with talking to somebody, you know, you can use emoji up the wazoo if you want, exclamation point, but it still doesn't, it's not like you're talking to somebody. Okay, so this person in particular I was talking with, and trying to arrange something, and she comes back, and apparently there was an unspoken rule I didn't know, and I broke it. Text, don't you love it? And so she came back to me, and she said that she felt like she was violated by me. Now, that's a heavy word, real big word. And I can say I have been violated before, and I know what that means, at least to me. So that's the space I went to, was that hurt. And I immediately got back to her, and I said, I am so sorry. I didn't realize, you know, I was trying to make it right, because that's just not who I am. And I sent her a card in the mail. Never heard anything back. And it hit me for a while, a bunch of days. I'm thinking, how am I who I am if somebody is having that experience because of me? Now, I'm not discounting her feeling. I'm not going to do that, because she had that feeling. Now, was that the right word that she chose? Probably not. But for me, it had me really sit and think about, what can I do with this energy? What can I do with this word, this energy that's coming towards me? And I sat with it for a while. 3 days later, I get a call from Reverend Bridget. She says, Barb, I would love it if you could be part of my installation ceremony. I'm thinking, this person here, Reverend Bridget, it's like God works in mysterious ways, but not so mysterious in this case, right? She called me and she said, I really, you know, we had an issue with teen camp. There were some people who got COVID there, so the ministers and the kids who were there, even though they don't have COVID, we just asked them to stay home. She said, you know, we thought about it, and you're like the person who we really want here to do this. And it's like she saw me, who I think I am. And so that helped settle things a little bit for me. Now, it's still, obviously, I can feel it. But it's something I get to work through. And then after the ceremony was over, Reverend Bridget said some amazing things again. And then the following Sunday, Reverend Marilyn came up to me and she said, thank you so much for covering for me. She said, I could really feel your energy coming over the airwaves. She knows me. She sees me. So I say, like Reverend Bridget talked about last week, I want to be a yay-sayer and not a nay-sayer. So whatever that experience was for me, I obviously needed to hear somehow, Barb, you're doing great. You're living the way that you need to live. You're living your light. And I got to hear that a number of times. Would that experience have happened anyway? Who knows? I don't know. But I needed to hear that. I can say I felt so blessed to be asked to be part of the ceremony, so blessed to be recognized in that way and to be part of this community, because you have already shown how spirit works, that higher power works through you by creating the space to bring Reverend Bridget here. You know that. We experience that together. There are no accidents. On Facebook, your purpose is not just the thing you do. It's the thing that happens to others when you do what you do. It's how you make people feel and remember you by doing what you do. It's the experiences that your energy leaves upon them. Right? 20-mile radius. Remember that next time you go out. Look around. recently I found this great experience for my four-year-old granddaughter. She's almost five, and it's called Kids Strong. And it's in Lake Oswego, and there's only one. They actually have franchised it now, but there's only one in Oregon, and it just happens to be locally, which is awesome. And it was created by these two PE teachers, a couple, who wanted to develop something for their little kids that they could participate in before they started getting into whatever. T-ball is probably the first, T-ball and soccer, probably the first ones at 6 years old or whatever. So this is age appropriate. It starts when they just start to walk to 11 years old, and they had different age ranges. And I found it for Quinn, and I want to tell you, this is what they're, what they say. They say, we help kids win at life. Science-based kids training program designed to help parents raise strong, confident, high-character kids. Our program focuses on character, physical, and brain development through weekly 45-minute age-based classes. We teach kids to be fearless, kind, smart, and brave. Isn't that cool? So, remember during the prayer? I am strong, I am brave, I can do this. That's where it comes from. And they're teaching kids at starting to walk, to say that, to know that, and believe it. Now, one of the things, so they set up obstacle course. So there's the physical part where they're running around. And then they start out the class, though, like this. It's the coolest thing. The kids sit on, they call them their Kids Strong dots, this little white dot that they all sit on, their own little dot. The teachers come up to them. They call them coaches. And the coach says, there are only three things we want to see from you right now. We want to see your eyes, we want a full sentence, and we want you to shake our hand. So the teacher goes up, the coach, they call him coach, goes up to each child. Child stands up. I'll use my name. I'll use Quinn, because she's the one doing it, because it's so fun to watch her. Hi, my name's Quinn. Nice to meet you. They shake hands. Then all the teachers go around. There are two teachers per class. So all the kids have stand up, acknowledge them. So they're learning communication skills. They're learning how to see eye to eye. Part of the communication as they go further along is public speaking. Can you imagine public speaking? So they have these platforms that are padded, that the whole area is padded. So they can jump off and crash and it doesn't matter. They stand up on this padded thing. Oh, I forgot to tell you. So right after they do the greeting, that's when all the kids stand up and they have a leader, and the leader leads them through, I am strong, and they repeat, I am strong, I am brave, I can do this. So feel that energy, okay? And then one class, I'll come back around, they had all the kids wait in line to stand up on these three different pads. They're like 3 feet high, they climb up there. And they have this remote for this TV, because they do a TV thing where they have kids sit in front of that sometimes to do mathematics, to do patterning, to do all these things. It is like, I wish there was one for me. I couldn't do some of the things they do. And so they have this fake microphone. They go, okay. And they're talking to all of us. There's like a 4-foot partition, glass, parents are all on the side. You can see everything that's going on inside. Kids are waving when they aren't focused on what they're doing because they're so active. So we're right there. So they're working on public speaking. Tell me what your favorite color is. And they go to each kid and they say, my favorite color, full sentences, my favorite color is black. And they jump off and go around and get in line. Well, a week after this experience I told you with my texting, so you know I was still, even though I was still feeling great because of the wonderful opportunity I had to be part of the ceremony here. So one of the questions they get up, Quinn's first, they said, who is your superhero? I don't know. So they go on to the next one, we'll come back to you. Who's your favorite super? One of the super kitties, Spider-Man. One of the kids said, Dad. And then they come back to Quinn, who's your favorite superhero? She goes, my favorite superhero is Nana. I'm Nana. So it's like, see how God works through everyone. It doesn't matter what age you are. kids have this amazing energy that it seems it's so much easier to get out there because they don't hold anything back. If they're in a pissy mood, they let you know. But they get over it and they go on. Unlike me, sometimes, rarely sometimes, I might hold on to it. Dr. Nelson said this, life is about having joy. It's about increasing our ability to give and receive love. And it's about gaining all of the knowledge we can. It's about serving others, feeling grateful for all that we have, and learning to create the life we want. We're meant to live vibrant, healthy lives filled with love, joy, and connection. Yes, yes. So let's be yay-sayers, not nay-sayers. A 1700 theologian, John Wesley, said this, do all the good you can, by all the means you can, in all the ways you can, in all the places you can, at all the times you can, to all the people you can, as long as ever you can. Because you can. And how do I know that? Because you're here. How do I know that you're strong? Because you're here. How do I know that you're brave? Because you're here. How do I know you can do it? Because you're here. So we're going to do this together. As you can, please stand up. As you're able, that is fine. Those of you at home, too, please stand up. If you're listening to this any other time, and if you're in a car, don't stand up. So the motions for those who aren't visually seeing this is, pretend you're a bodybuilder and your arms go up to the side and you're showing your muscles. That is strong. And then the arms go down to the sides like you're Superman or Wonder Woman. And that is, I am brave. And then both arms in front with two thumbs up. And that is, I can do it. Okay, so you guys remember at the beginning the 20-mile radius? Okay, we're like going beyond 20 miles right now. All right, so I'm going to say it. You repeat after me. And I want to hear it like you know that you are the most special person in the world right now. I am strong.
I am strong.
I am brave.
I am brave.
I can do this.
I can do this.
Yes, you can. High five somebody next to you. High five. High ten. All right. We can do it. We can do it. All right. Go ahead and have a seat. Yes. 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 Will you remember that when you get home?
Yes.
If you ever notice, for some reason, that your energy is a little swizzly someday, just do it. Be your brave person. Be strong. Be brave. And just give yourself two thumbs up. Because I know you can do it. I know, I know, I know, I know. Blessings to all of you.
Thank you, Reverend Barbara. So this is our time of sacred giving. Thank you so much for your gracious giving. Your financial gifts enable us to be in this beautiful space, enjoy wonderful music, hear inspirational speakers, be inclusive of our virtual spiritual community, and support community nonprofits. They allow this powerful teaching to be known so we can continue to grow and be an expression of spirit into the world. In a moment, our ushers will please come forward. Our ushers will come around the sanctuary with a basket, and if your preferred contribution is cash, please tuck it in an envelope in the seat backs with your name on it. We welcome financial donations from our virtual spiritual community online. And all ways to contribute are at cslportland.org under the donate heading. Will the ushers please step forward? So let us accept and bless our offering together as a call and response. I bless these sacred gifts.
I bless these sacred gifts.
Given graciously with love.
Given graciously with love.
These gifts bless, heal, and prosper all they touch.
These gifts bless, heal, and prosper all they touch.
In giving, I am grateful to be richly.
In giving, I am grateful to be richly.
Lavishly.
Lavishly.
And abundantly blessed.
And abundantly blessed.
And so it is.
And so it is.
And now I welcome our musicians.
I feel like we should be singing, "Don't Stop Believing," but this is just as good. Yes. Thank you for that talk. And I wish that I had something like that when I was a kid that Quinn has. Because I remember teachers just saying, "Lauri needs to interact more with the other kids. She's so shy." Like I was shamed, you know, instead of just like, well, I didn't, you know, to have that though at a young age is so powerful. We need more of that. But it's not too late because this you know, New Thought Teachings gives us that. But I still wish I had it when I was a kid. Oh, I could light the night up with my soul on fire.
God energy. Yes, yes, yes. Oh, I love it. I love it. 50 miles now, at least. 50 miles now. So just know that if there's anything you desire prayer for, anything going on in your life, joys, sorrows, whatever that is, now's the time with this energy here. You can come up and meet with practitioners afterwards and at home. I think that you can put prayers online and you'll get answered back. And also there's a prayer request box back there if you want to write out your prayer. Know that they go to the ministers and practitioners and you are held in love and light with that specific prayer for the whole week. Isn't that nice? So, time to stand up and grab the hand of the person next to you. Ah, feel that vibration. Woo! And then repeat after me. Something wonderful is happening to me right now.
Something wonderful is happening to me right now.
It's this thing called life.
It's this thing called life.
Life is in my mind.
Life is in my mind.
Life is in my body.
Life is in my body.
And life is in my affairs.
Life is in my affairs.
I think it.
I think it.
I believe it.
I believe it.
I accept it.
I accept it.
I am it.
I am it.
Just the way that I am.
Just the way I am.
Woohoo! Okay, you can drop your hands and let's do our closing song.
We let the love wash over us.
We hope you enjoyed today's podcast. If you happen to be in the Portland, Oregon area, we'd love to have you visit in person. The Portland Center for Spiritual Living is located at 6211 Northeast Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard. Our inspirational service is at 11 a.m. every Sunday. We also have many programs, classes, and workshops developed just for our online audience. To find out more, go to our website at cslportland.org. And look under the online tab. We have a variety of content dedicated specifically for our podcast listeners. Our mission is to open hearts, ignite minds, and make a difference. If you'd like to support our center and its podcasts, you can donate online at cslportland.org/donate. Our website is also the place to learn more about what's going on at the center or to contact us. Allow us to become part of your extended spiritual community. Wherever you are in your spiritual journey, you are most welcome at the Center for Spiritual Living.